For as long as I can remember, my dad has told me to be happy. A couple of weeks ago, I had a test in every class, I had to work late, and I was feeling a lot of anxiety. That's when he came into my room, he told me to calm down, take a deep breath. Then he asked me, "What do you want from life?" "Well," a few minutes later he said, "What is it? What do you want?" I responded with happiness. What a word. It means so many different things to so many different people. Some might describe it as a feeling they have when they get to start the game, or they get the lead role in the play, or get an A on a test. But others, they take it as their motto. They see happiness as a choice that they make day in and day out, not only for themselves, but for the people around them. Happiness, of course, makes you happy, but it's not a superficial feeling that just goes away. According to author John Zelensky, the more time spent being happy, the more productive an individual is, and subsequently, the better the quality of work they have. At first, it takes a lot of conscious thought to be happy. For me, it took years. But after that conscious thought, I came up with my life motto. That is, think what you want from life. What do I want the end goal to be? When I'm 70 years old, I don't want to look back and say, if only I had spent more time being happy. And now that I've made happiness a priority for me, it becomes a lot easier, and I've spent more time being happy. It's refreshing to know that I spend another day, one more day being happy than not. Like Charlie Chaplin says, a day without laughter is a day wasted. You can be happy too. There's three steps that I follow to get to my happiness. One is if you are faced with an unhappy situation, that you change your thinking into becoming happier. Two, every morning ask yourself, what is it that you want from your life? And if that life or if that day is something, if it has anything to do with happiness, then make sure that when you think happy thoughts, and then you end your day on a high note. And thirdly, don't spend your time thinking about the little minor inconveniences. Don't put any unhappy thought into that, because it's not going to be important to you from 20 years from now. To close out, I'd like to say a quote that my psychology teacher said to me one day, and that really resonated with me. She said, "To truly succeed in life, we must be able to find happiness." Thank you.